this is geared more towards the children. Listen to what the listen to all these characteristics here. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truth breakers, false accusers, incontent, fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasure more than lovers of God, having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, from such turn away. The thing that I want you children to understand right there is you listen to all those things that God says is going to happen, and He put disobedient to parents right in the middle of that mess. I tell you what, kids, you need to honor mom and dad. If you got a godly mom and dad, you better thank God for them. And I tell you what, being disobedient to your parents, God puts you right in the middle of the same of that mess right there.
Amen.
And I tell you what, I heard Brother Jack Howells preach on that one day. And boy, I tell you what, I never thought about that, Brother Dean. Disobedient to parents was in there with all that other ungodly crowd. But notice there in verse 5, having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, from such turn away. Then on down to verse number 7, it says, ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. You want to know why folks can't get in and understand the old King James Bible? Because they've never had no discernment. They've never truly been saved and born again. It's amazing to me, folks, that we're living in the most educated times as a nation as a whole. We're living in the most educated times. We've got the smartest people in the world, but yet they can't understand the old King James Bible that Grandma and Grandpa, who didn't have no education, understood. But I tell you what's wrong with that crowd. They've never been saved. The devil's gone on and slipped that crowd a counterfeit.
Yes,
folks, it's sad. It's sad, glory to God.
Yes.
Romans chapter number 3. Romans chapter number 3. I told you I was going to flip you to death. Y'all don't have to turn with me. You don't have to keep up with me. I understand. Romans chapter number 3, verses 13 through 18.
Amen.
Romans 3, 13 through 18. Their throat is an open sepulcher. With their tongues they have used deceit. Their poison of asp under their lips, whose mouth is full of cursing and bitterness. Their feet are swift to shed blood. Destruction and misery are in their ways, and the way of peace have they known not. There is no fear of God before their eyes. Folks, I tell you what, we're living in that day right
Amen.
There. I'm talking about the folks that's supposed to be saved by the grace
sir.
Of God.
Amen.
The Bible right there, it says that about those folks also.
Amen.
How sad. John chapter number 15. John chapter number 15. I remember the first time I preached this message, my pastor said, you about wore my fingers out that night. I said, well, you pray for me. It's the first time I ever preached. John 15, 18 and 19. It says, if the world hates you, you know that it hated me before it hated you. If you were of the world would love his own. But because you are not of the world, but I have chosen you out of the world, therefore the world hateth you.
Amen.
I tell you what, you want to know why the world don't want to come out of the old-fashioned tent tonight? Brother Dean done said it. You want to know why, I don't remember who it was they was talking about. You want to know the very first word popped in my mind when they was talking about somebody's family here. They didn't want to come around and talk to them because they was afraid they was going to get preached to. Folks, that's called conviction.
Amen.
That's called conviction. The world hates you tonight. The world knows that you take a stand for God. And I'm telling you what, I thank God for old-fashioned conviction. I'm just going to tell you right now, there's 90% of the crowd that I work with hate my guts. They don't like me. I tell you what, the world says if you love Jesus and you try to serve Him, folks, they're going to hate you.
Amen.
I tell you what, you run that devil's crowd, you start hooking up with them, boy, they'll be your friend for a little while.
Amen.
I'm telling you what, they'll love you. They'll say, Brother Dean, we like you. You want to go down to the beer joint with us tonight? You want to go play cards with us? No, brothers, I'm going to old-fashioned tent meeting tonight. I'm going to revival. Bless God, revival, revival, revival. That's
Amen.
All we ever hear. Bless God, won't you take that mess and go somewhere else?
Yeah.
They don't want the thing we got.
Right.
But deep down, folks, they really do.
Yeah.
They really do.
Yes,
I tell you what, there'll come a day in time, and I'm not bragging on me. I don't want you to think I'm bragging on me. I'm not.
Right. Amen.
These two folks last week that called me needing some help, Brother Dean. Lost
Amen.
Folks.
Amen.
I tell you what, they wouldn't have a thing to do with this old preacher.
Right.
They called me last week wanting some help, needing some help.
Amen.
I tell you what, folks, that crowd ought to know who to call. Brother Chaz told me many times, I tell you what, he couldn't give me $1 million to make me any more happy. He said, you want to know why I started coming up to your church? And I see, he said, because I seen something different in you at work. He said, I seen a difference in your life. Bless God, that ought to be the testimony of every one of us here tonight. They ought to be something different. We ought not have a counterfeit that I tell you what, that most folks have. I'm afraid that most folks have that tonight.
Amen.
Lord mercy, God. John, 1 John 1:6 says, if we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not the truth.
Yes.
Jesus calls him a liar. He calls that crowd a liar. He says, if we say we have fellowship and then we walk in darkness like that crowd does, he's calling us a liar.
Right.
Folks, I tell you what, I don't know who they think they're hiding from. I don't know who they think they're running from. I tell you what, we're living in a day when, like I say, people sitting in the church pews that are addicted to pornography, they're probably having an affair with somebody within the church. And you say, I don't know who they think they're hiding it from. They may hide it from the preacher. They may hide it from you. Bless God, they'll not hide it from God.
Right.
God sees it all.
Yes, sir.
And they're going to answer for it.
Amen.
1 John 2:15-17. 1 John 2:15-17. Love not the world, neither things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh and the lust of the eyes, pride of life, is not of the Father, but is of the world. We're living in a time, folks, when folks love this world. I tell you what, they love the things of the world. And nobody wants to die. We don't want to die. I'm not saying that. I'd be foolish if I told you tonight that I wanted to just go out tonight and die. I mean, yeah, things would be easier, but you know what? I'd like to stay here as long as I can and see my little girl, you know, grow up and see folks saved, spend time with my wife and enjoying fellowship.
Yeah.
But I know tonight, though, folks, if I die and I don't make it back here tomorrow, I'm in a better place.
Amen.
But I tell you what, love not the world, neither things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. I'm glad this world ain't my home. I'm glad I'm just a pilgrim and a stranger passing through. I may be in this world, but I'm not of this world, Brother Dave. I'm glad I'm going to a better place called heaven someday. Revelation chapter number 3, verses 15 and 16 says, I know thy works, that thou art neither hot, neither cold nor hot. Thou wert cold or hot. So then because thou art lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will spew thee out of my mouth. I believe tonight, I wrote this down, lukewarm water makes a disgusting drink. The lad that's in church, he become lukewarm and thus distasteful. The believers didn't stand for anything, and indifference had led to idleness. By neglecting to do anything for Christ, the church had become hardened and self-satisfied. It was destroying itself. Don't settle for following God halfway. Let Christ fire up the faith in you and get action. I tell you what, we're living in a day where lukewarm Christians. I tell you what, God says you're neither hot nor you're cold. He said, it makes me sick. I want to vomit you out of my mouth, what he's saying. He said, it makes me sick. I'd rather you just be on fire for God or just sit back and not do nothing. It makes God sick. Boy, I tell you what. And when we sit in churches Sunday after Sunday, and we go out here, and we sing, oh, how I love Jesus on Sunday morning, and live like pure tea hell, and live like the devil 6 days a week, God says, I'd rather just vomit you out of my mouth. That makes him sick. That makes him sick. Revelation 20, verse number 11 through 15. Revelation chapter number 20, verses 11 through 15. It's the final judgment. I saw a great white throne, and him that sat on it, from whose face and earth, heaven fled away, and there was found no place for them. And I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God, and the books were opened, and another book was opened, which is the book of life. And the dead were judged out of those things which are written in the books according to their works. And the sea gave up the dead which were in it, and death and hell delivered it up, the dead which were in them, and they were judged, every man according to their works, and death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death, and whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire.
Amen.
And in Revelation 14:11 says, and the smoke of their torment ascendeth up forever and ever, and they have no rest, day or night. I've got more scripture that I